Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna be trying Michelin Star Instant Ramen. So what makes this cup instant ramen Michelin Star? So for this, Nissin actually partnered with Nakiryu, which is a ramen shop in Tokyo. Nakiryu earned one Michelin Star for its dandan noodles, which is what these are. It is one of the two ramen shops in Tokyo that have a Michelin Star rating. So this is basically an instant ramen version of the Michelin Star dandan noodles. This is sold all across Japan in grocery stores, and you can also get it at the konbini. This one is from 7-Eleven. And a huge shout out to Jan for snagging me this one. Head to the link in my description to check out her channel. Ramen in general is pretty cheap, but since this is instant ramen, this is actually only 200 yen, which is a little under $2. That is some affordable Michelin Star food. So they do have the taller, skinnier bowls that they sell that look more like typical instant ramen, but this one is the bigger, rounder one, which I usually associate with better tasting instant ramen. It has the Michelin rating on the front and a picture of the delicious ramen that looks so good. And on the side, it has sort of like a wood tone to make it look like a fancier bowl. The packaging is actually pretty nice and delicious looking. So opening it up, you have the noodles, and then you have three packets. So the red one is like a sesame oil, the green one is a wet soup base, and then there's a dry soup packet that has all the dried goodies in it. This is supposed to be one of the best instant ramen that you could possibly eat. I've never actually had the original, so I can't really compare it yet. I'm gonna try to go so that way I can see what it actually tastes like, but I'm really stoked to try this because I heard it tastes actually quite similar to the original. Like other instant ramen, it's pretty easy to make, so I'm gonna put it together and try it out. Okay, I waited 3 minutes and I mixed it together. Since it's mixed, the oils haven't separated, so it's actually not as bright red as it is in the picture. But there is some little meat and stuff. It smells really good. It smells like sesame, and it smells pretty thick, so. Itadakimasu. This is actually really good. It's super flavorful. The meat's really good. It's a little spicy. It's actually not as spicy as I thought it was going to be. I feel like I should be dressed better. I'm wearing like a sweatshirt that's like cat fur and says meow and like running leggings, right? I look sort of like trash, but as Justin, my roommate, was saying, that's the perks of getting Michelin Star ramen at home, is you could look like trash and eat like a king. Oh, I just splashed it in my face. You wanna try some, Justin?
Sure.
This is Justin.
Hello. I'm gonna try some of this.
Yes.
Looks all fancy.
I know, it tastes fancy.
It's pretty good. It's got meat in it too.
Yeah, try the meat. The meat's actually good.
Wow, that's nice.
Yeah.
It's a good breakfast.
Right? Breakfast for us, it's like 12.
Yeah. So
Justin really liked the soup and the fact that there's like actual meat chunks in here, which is probably my favorite part about it too. It's really good. So if you can get your hands on this, highly recommend trying it. If you've had this in Nakiryu in the shop in Tokyo, let me know how you thought that this compared, if you've also had the instant ramen, because I've never been to the shop, so I'm not really sure. Kasha? But yeah, overall, super, super good. Two thumbs up. Or maybe four, if Justin gives it two thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure to like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments if you've had this before, and other things that you want me to try. Thanks again, and I will see you in my next video. Mata ne! So hello, an update from my phone, but I just finished all of it, which is so rare for me. I usually don't eat yome ramen. It was really good. Bye now.